Welcome back to Le Podcast de Philippe. Today we're doing a deep dive into something pretty interesting. Have you heard about Comet?
Comet.
Yeah, it's
like the heavenly body.
Well, no, not quite like that. Yeah. It's a potential new web browser.
Oh wow. Okay.
Yeah, and the really interesting part is that it's being developed by Perplexity, the AI company.
Right, right. The folks behind that really powerful AI search engine.
Exactly. So we're going to be taking a look at what we know about it, how it could change how we use the web, and yeah, maybe it could even shake things up a little bit.
Yeah, because the browser market, that's a tough nut to crack.
It is.
You got those big players like Chrome dominating everything.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. So speaking of shaking things up, we're actually trying to hit 1,000 subscribers on YouTube today.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so if you haven't subscribed yet, please do. It would really help us out. All right, so let's get into Comet. I mean, a new browser from an AI company, it's got to be something special, right?
Yeah. That right there, that really piques my curiosity. Like every few years you hear about a new browser, this is going to change everything. But
right.
This time, with Perplexity's AI expertise behind it, it feels like it could actually be different this time.
Yeah, yeah. And they're already doing such cool things with their search engine.
Totally.
So what makes Comet different from just, you know, using the Perplexity search engine in like Chrome or Firefox?
So Comet's designed from the ground up for what Perplexity calls agentic search. Have you heard of that?
Agentic search? No, I haven't. It sounds kind of a...
That's a fancy way of saying that it's about more than just finding information. It's about actually taking action.
Taking action.
Yeah. So imagine you're in your browser. You're booking a flight, researching a super complex topic, even managing your to-do list. And Comet's using AI to help you do all of that, like, seamlessly. Right there in the browser.
Okay, so it's not just about searching smarter. It's about actually doing more, you know, within the browser itself.
Mm.
Is it kind of like, I don't know, like an AI assistant?
You know,
yeah.
Like built right into the browser.
Right, right.
It's a good way to put it. But it's more than just an assistant. Like Comet is supposed to like predict your needs, you know, give you suggestions, even automate tasks. It could be amazing.
That would be pretty game changing.
Right.
In terms of efficiency and just like personalizing your whole experience online. So how would that like actually work? What would that look like in practice?
So think about this. You're planning a trip, right? Comet could potentially look at your emails, look at your calendar, see your travel dates, your destination, and then boom, pull together flight options, recommend hotels, even suggest things to do based on your interests.
Wow.
All without you having to jump around to a million different sites.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
And from what I've read, it sounds like, you know, it's going to be way more interactive and customizable than what we're used to.
Right. And Perplexity is talking about like natural language commands. So imagine just telling your browser what to do.
Yeah.
Or typing it out. Simple instructions. And they're promising like next level personalization.
Oh, wow.
It goes way beyond just, you know, changing your theme or saving bookmarks.
Oh, okay. So like what would that actually look like? Like how would it change the way that, you know, I use a browser every day?
Imagine setting up Comet to like automatically create reports, like pull in data from specific websites, or say you're super interested in a topic. Comet could like gather all these articles and research papers, summarize the main points for you, boom.
That sounds amazing. It sounds like having a personal research assistant right there in your browser.
Exactly.
So how does Comet fit in with all the other, you know, AI tools and services that are out there right now? I mean, there are so many.
So Comet is like deeply connected to Perplexity's world. You know, they've got their deep search feature and that Sonar API.
Yeah.
Comet's designed to work seamlessly with all of that.
So it's not just like a standalone browser. Mm-hmm. It's really part of this bigger, you know, AI ecosystem.
Right. And that's what makes it so interesting.
That makes sense.
Strategically.
Yeah. But, you know, let's be real. It's going up against some huge competition.
Oh, yeah.
Chrome, Edge, Firefox, they all have like massive user bases and, you know, tons of resources.
Absolutely. They're the big guys.
So what do you think? Does Comet have a chance?
Well, you know, those big browsers, they're mainly built on old school browsing tech.
Right.
And Comet being so tightly integrated with Perplexity's AI, that gives it a real edge, a unique advantage.
It's bringing something new to the table. What about Comet surprised you? Like, what's the most innovative thing about it?
You know what stood out to me?
Hmm.
The emphasis on making Comet really automated and customizable. Like, they're really laser focused on those user pain points, those things that frustrate us with our current browsers.
So they're not just trying to, you know, make a slightly better version of what we already have.
Right.
They're really trying to change the whole concept of what a browser can be.
Exactly.
That's a pretty bold move.
It is. And it'll be fascinating to see where it goes. It really is pushing those boundaries. That's what makes Comet so intriguing.
Yeah, absolutely. You mentioned earlier that it's, you know, still in development,
mm-hmm.
not publicly available yet.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So what's the latest? Like, when can people actually get their hands on it?
Well, you know, Perplexity is accepting signups for a beta version right now on their website, perplexity.acomet.
Oh, okay. So our listeners can actually get an early peek if they want.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll be sure to put that link in the show notes. But even though, you know, it's early, it's still fun to speculate. Like, how could Comet change how we use the internet?
Yeah.
You know, on a day-to-day basis.
You know, I think we might be looking at a shift from, like, passive browsing to something much more active and personalized.
Okay.
Imagine this. Instead of, like, hunting down information, you know, across all these different websites and apps, you've got this browser that's anticipating what you need.
Right.
It's proactively giving you relevant stuff.
Okay, so it's streamlining, like, how we access and process information. What implications do you see for things like research?
Research?
Education.
Oh, yeah.
Even just, you know, how we stay informed about the news.
It could be huge. Like, imagine students researching super complex topics, but it's effortless because they've got this AI helping them find and understand all this information.
No.
Professionals staying up to date on their industry with these personalized news feeds, automated summaries.
It sounds like Comet could, like, democratize knowledge.
Yeah.
Make it easier for everyone to learn, understand things, no matter their technical skills.
I think so.
But you know, we gotta acknowledge there are potential downsides as well, right? I mean, it's not all sunshine and roses.
Of course. Any new tech, especially one that's using AI, there's always risks.
Right.
Security is a big one. I mean, right. A browser that has access to so much of your personal information, wow. It's got to be super secure to prevent data breaches, you know, to protect privacy.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's also the question of, like, control.
Oh, yeah.
If the browser is doing so much automatically, like, how much control do I actually have as a user?
Yeah.
Am I being steered in directions that I don't want to go?
Those are valid concerns. And it's something Perplexity needs to be transparent about.
Right.
If they want people to feel good about using Comet, you know, finding that balance between AI power and user control, that'll be interesting to watch.
It's a tough one. And as we've seen with other AI,
yeah.
You know, there's always the risk of unintended consequences.
Absolutely. Developers, they got to think about the ethical implications of AI. Really design these systems with, you know, human values in mind.
So it's not just a technological challenge.
Yeah.
It's almost like a philosophical one as well.
Yeah.
It's not just a new piece of software. It's like potentially a whole new way of interacting with the digital world.
Right. And that's what makes it so fascinating to talk about. It's not just the nuts and bolts of Comet. It's that big picture of how AI is changing the internet, our place in it.
And it's a reminder that technology is never neutral, right?
Oh, for sure.
It always reflects the values of the people who build it,
mm-hmm.
the societies that use it.
Very well said. And I think it's so important that we approach these new things with a sense of, like, excitement, but also with critical thinking.
Right.
You know, we got to think about the potential benefits, the risks, engage in those thoughtful discussions about how we can shape the future of AI in a way that benefits everyone.
Yeah, it's a conversation we all need to be a part of. And speaking of conversations, let's bring it back to our listeners for a moment. We've been talking about, you know, Comet, what it could do. But let's flip it for a second. Like, if you could design your dream AI browser, what would it have? Like, what problems would you want it to solve?
Oh, that's a good question. It's almost like we're so used to browsers as they are that it's tough to imagine something totally different. But that's what's cool about AI, you know? It lets us rethink things.
Yeah. You know, one thing I would love is a browser that really gets, like, the context of what I'm doing online.
Oh, interesting.
So, like, imagine I'm writing an email and the browser's, like, smart enough to suggest relevant files from my cloud storage.
Right.
Without me having to go search for them.
That would be amazing. Like, just making things so much smoother, you know,
yeah.
And more efficient. But it could go even further than that. Like, what if the browser could, like, understand your big goals?
Oh, okay.
And help you reach them. So say you're working on a research project.
Yeah.
Not only could it help you find information, but it could help you organize it, analyze it, even like put it all together into a report.
So it's like having a research partner built right in.
Exactly.
But then that raises, some other questions.
Of course.
If browsers get that powerful, that integrated into our lives, what about our privacy?
Privacy is key. Any AI browser would have to have like rock solid privacy protections. Users have got to have full control of their data, how it's used, and transparency's got to be huge too.
Right.
Users need to know like what information's being collected, how it's being used, all of that.
So it's not just about the tech.
No.
It's about building trust.
100%. And that trust, that's what's going to make people comfortable using these new tools. It's a two-way street, right?
Yeah.
Developers have got to be responsible, they got to be transparent, and users, they got to be informed, they got to be part of the conversation about how AI is used.
Exactly. And that's a conversation that, we hope we've kind of started here today on Le Podcast de Philippe.
It's been great exploring all of this with you.
And to our listeners, thanks for joining us for this deep dive into Comet and the future of web browsing. We've only just scratched the surface, but hopefully this has given you some things to think about. We encourage you to keep exploring this topic and let us know what you think. What do you think the future of browse could be? And hey, if you enjoyed this episode, please hit that subscribe button. Help us get to 1,000 subscribers on YouTube today. Until next time, stay curious.